Hello all, welcome to Let's Learn Optometry. In this video, we will see about the anatomy of sclera. Sclera is the white portion of the eye. In this picture, the white portion is the sclera and the grey portion is the cornea. We already know that the cornea is transparent and the color which we see is the color of the iris, which is a part located behind the cornea. It is an opaque structure. Unlike cornea, sclera is an opaque structure. We will see the reason for this later in this video. Sclera forms the posterior 5/6 of the eyeball and the anterior 1/6 is by the cornea. It is the outer fibrous coat of the eye. We knew that the eye has three layers. The outer fibrous coat called sclera, the middle vascular coat called choroid, and the inner neural coat called retina. Among these three layers, the outer fibrous coat is sclera. The whole sclera is covered by a structure called Tenon's capsule. In addition to Tenon's capsule, the anterior portion of the sclera is covered by bulbar conjunctiva also. In this picture, the blue membrane is Tenon's capsule and the gap between the Tenon's capsule and the sclera is called subtenon space. The anesthesia given in this space is called subtenon anesthesia. The inner surface of the sclera lies in contact with the choroid, with the suprachoroidal space in between them. So, what are all the functions of sclera? Protection. It protects the intraocular contents from trauma, injury or inflammations. Shape. Together with the intraocular pressure, it gives a proper shape to the eyeball. Muscle attachment. The firmness and rigidity of the sclera provides a good space for the attachment of muscles. Thickness. The thickness of the sclera varies between different individuals and different ages. It is normally thinner in children compared to adults and thinner in females compared to males. The sclera is thickest posteriorly at about 1 mm and gradually thin when traced anteriorly. Now we will see some special regions of the sclera. Sulcus. It is an indentation or furrow on the inner surface of the sclera near the limbus. Sclerm's canal, which is one of the important part in aqueous drainage, is located in this sulcus. Scleral spur. It is a circular flange of anterior most part of the sclera which lies deep to the Sclerm's canal. It appears wedge shaped in cross section and is known as scleral spur. The meridional fibers of the ciliary muscles are attached to the scleral spur. Lamina cribrosa. It is a sieve-like structure located at the posterior most part of the sclera through which the fibers of the optic nerve passes. The sclera is very weak at this region, so it bulges outwards in response to the high intraocular pressure for a prolonged period of time and produce optic disc cupping. Sclera has some aperture or otherwise called as openings. There are three aperture: posterior, middle and anterior. These apertures are important as the vessels and nerves passes through this aperture. Posterior aperture are situated around the optic nerve and it transmit the long and short ciliary vessels and nerves. Middle aperture are situated 4 to 7 mm posterior to the equator of the eyeball. Through this aperture passes vortex veins. Anterior aperture are situated 3 to 4 mm away from the limbus and through this aperture anterior ciliary vessels, perivascular lymphatics and ciliary nerves passes. Microscopic structure of the sclera. The sclera has three layers. The outermost episclera, the middle stroma or otherwise called as sclera proper, and the inner lamina fusca. Episcleral tissue. It is the outermost layer of the sclera. It is a thin layer of connective tissue. It is dense vascularized layer. Anteriorly, it becomes continuous with the tenon capsule. Posteriorly, it merges with the sclera proper. The capillary network present in this layer becomes prominent during inflammations. Apart from vessels and nerves, it also contains bundle of collagen fibrils, keratocytes and melanocytes. Episclera becomes progressively thinner towards the back of the eye. Sclera proper. It is an avascular structure. It consists of collagen fibers, elastic fibers, fibroblasts and ground substance. The collagen fibers present in this layer are arranged in an irregular manner. This is the reason why the sclera is opaque, unlike in cornea, where the collagen fibers are arranged in an orderly manner, which makes cornea transparent. With advancing age, the fibers become sclerosed and there also occurs some deposition of lipids. So consequently, the sclera becomes yellow as we age. Lamina fusca. It is the innermost part of the sclera. It blends with the supracoroidal and supraciliary lamina of the uveal tract. It is brownish in color due to the presence of pigmented cells. Lamina fusca and choroid are connected by a fine collagen fibers that provides a weak attachment between sclera and the choroid. This picture shows how an eye will look like when the outer coverings are torn away from the sclera. The outermost is the conjunctiva, which has some blood vessels in it, then the tenon capsule, then episclera, and finally the scleral stroma. Blood supply of the sclera. Episclera is supplied by the anterior ciliary artery, long and short posterior ciliary arteries. Stroma. It is an avascular structure. It receives its nutrition from episcleral vascular bed and underlying choroidal vasculature. Nerve supply. Nerve supply is from branches of long ciliary nerves anteriorly and short ciliary nerves behind the equator. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit a like and share this video and subscribe to